Now let's see about deadlock characterization. Deadlock characterization is nothing but deadlock description. We can describe a deadlock with the help of resource allocation graph. Resource allocation graph is nothing but a normal graph only. We know that a graph is represented with the help of a pair called V, E, where V represents a set of vertices, E represents a set of edges. Here vertices are nothing but processes and resource types. Every process is represented with the help of a circle, whereas resource type is represented with the help of a square. If you take a printer, printer is a resource type. It assumes that 5 printers are connected to the computer. So now they are known as 5 instances of the resource type. Each instance is specified with the help of a dot symbol. So how many printers are connected to the computer? 5 printers. So we have to use just 5 dots here. Let us assume that resource type is a RAM. Assumes that 2 RAMs are connected to the computer. So we can specify here 2 dots. So these are nothing but instances. So instances of the resource type. So RAM is the resource type, and how many RAMs we connected? 2 RAMs. So they are specified with the help of dots. Let's see the second one. What is the second one? Edges. Here mainly there are 2 types of edges are available. The first edge is request edge. The first edge is request edge, whereas the second edge is assignment edge, or can also be known as allocated edge. So what is the first edge? Request edge. Second edge, assignment edge or allocated edge. So whenever a process wants to use a resource, then first the corresponding process puts a request for the resource. So this request is known as request edge. So here PI wants to use an instance of the resource RJ. So PI will put a request for RJ. So this edge is known as request edge. Suppose if RJ is free, then operating system allocates RJ to PI. So this edge is known as assignment edge or allocated edge. So request edge means it goes from process to resource, whereas assignment or allocated edge means it goes from resource to the process. Now let's see this example, resource allocation graph example. Here we have 2 graphs here. Let us take the first one. Here we have 3 processes in the system, P1, P2, P3 and 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 resource types in the system. The first resource type is R1. R1 contains 1 instance. The second resource type is R2. R2 contains 2 instances. Third resource type is R3. R3 contains a single instance. Fourth resource type is R4. R4 contains 3 instances. Let us observe about P3 here. Here P3 is holding an instance of resource type R3. Next to P2 is holding an instance of resource type R2. And P2 is waiting for an instance of resource type R3. Next, if you observe about P1, so P1 is holding an instance of resource type R2. If it is holding, then directly we can start the line from this dot onwards. Okay. Next, P1 is waiting for an instance of resource type R1. Okay. So this is the resource allocation graph here. And then check whether this graph is producing any deadlock or not. Okay. Here, how many resources does P3 require? P3 requires only 1 resource, that is R3. So already R3 is allocated to P3. So P3 can complete its execution with R3. So once P3 execution is over, then P3 can release R3, and that R3 will be allocated to P2 now. So now P2 has R2 as well as R3. So P2 completes its execution with R2 and R3. So once P2 execution is over, it releases both R2 and R3. So R2 will be allocated to this R1. Yeah, it releases R1. Yeah, this R1 will be allocated to P1. So now P1 contains R1 as well as R2. So P1 can complete its execution with R1 and R2. So we can say that here there is no deadlock. Check whether this graph contains any cycle or not. So actually this graph contains a cycle. Okay. This graph doesn't contain any cycle. Here we don't have any cycle. So there is no deadlock here. Okay. So here the point is, if the graph doesn't contain any cycle, then there is no deadlock. Here we don't have any cycle, so there is no deadlock. Here let us establish a new edge from P3 to R2. So that means now P3 is holding an instance of resource type R3, as well as P3 is waiting for an instance of R2. So now does P1 or P2 or P3 can complete their executions? No. So P3 is waiting for R3 and R2, but this R2 is allocated to P1 and P2. So P1 can't release R2, P2 can't release R2 until they are completed its execution. So likewise, P2 is waiting for R3, but R3 is allocated to P3. P3 cannot release R3. So likewise, P1 is waiting for R1, but R1 is allocated to P2. P2 can't release R1. So we can say that this system contains a deadlock. Let us check whether this graph contains any cycle or not. If you observe this path, here we have a cycle. So this is a cycle. So if the graph contains a cycle, then there may be a possibility that deadlock may occur. Okay, so this is nothing but resource allocation graph. So this graph contains cycle, so with cycle and deadlock. Now let's check whether this graph contains any cycle or not. Here if you observe this graph, so the first one is P1. So P1 is waiting for an instance of resource type R1, and it is holding an instance of resource type R2. Next, if you observe about P2, P2 is holding an instance of resource type R1. Next, P3 is holding an instance of resource type R1. And P3 is waiting for an instance of resource type R2. If you observe about P4, so P4 is holding an instance of resource type R2. So how many resources does P2 requires? Only one resource, that is R1. And already R1 is allocated to P2. So P2 can complete its execution with R1. So once its execution is over, then P2 releases the R1. So that R1 can be allocated to P2 now. Next, how many resources does P4 requires? Only one resource, that is R2. So P4 can complete its execution with R2. So once P4 execution is over, then it can release the R2. So that R2 can be allocated to P3. So P3 can complete its execution with R1 as well as R2. And after that, it releases the corresponding resources. Those resources are allocated to P1. So P1 can complete its execution. So here we can say that there is no deadlock. Let's check whether this graph is producing any cycle or not. So this is a cycle. Okay, so this is nothing but a resource allocation graph with cycle but no deadlock. So here the point is very simple. If resource allocation graph doesn't contains any cycle, then there is no deadlock. Suppose if the resource allocation graph contains a cycle, and if the resource type contains a single instance, if all the resource types in the graph contains single instance, then there must be a deadlock. Whereas if the resource types contains multiple instances, then there may be a possibility that deadlock may occur or may not occur. So here we have two points. What is the first point? If there is no cycle, then there is no deadlock. Second point, if there is a cycle, then we have two sub points. If there is a cycle and if all the resource types contains single instance, if all the resource types in the graph contains single instance, then deadlock must occur. Why? Because the resource type contains single instance means every process will wait for that resource. but that resource is allocated to some other process. That process can't release that resource until and unless it has completed its execution. So here, if all the resource types contains a single instance as well as there is a cycle, then we can say that there must be a deadlock. Whereas if the resource type contains multiple instances as well as there is a cycle, then there is a possibility that deadlock may occur or may not occur. If you take these two diagrams, this diagram contains cycle as well as this diagram also contains cycle, but here we have a deadlock, here we don't have any deadlock. So in this way we can represent a deadlock with the help of resource allocation graph.